Since they did away with Google Plus, creating a YouTube brand account is a little complicated. If you're watching this video, you probably already know the differences between a YouTube brand account and a YouTube personal account, but if you don't know the differences or you're not sure which account you should have, go ahead and skip towards the end of this video and watch that first. Now, let's make a YouTube brand account. First thing we want to do is log into YouTube. So in the top right corner, go ahead and click on sign in. And then you want to put in your email address, which I'll do here, and then my password. And now we'll be logged into YouTube. You can tell by seeing your profile icon in the top right corner, it'll show you what email you're logged in with. So then after that, we're going to go ahead and scroll down to settings. You can also just get to this page by going to youtube.com/account, but in the left, you'll see the advanced settings tab. So go ahead and click that. And here you'll be able to tell whether you have a personal account or a brand account. If you currently have a personal account, you'll see move channel to brand account displayed here. So that means we have a personal account. So since we want a brand account, we're gonna go ahead and click on this. And it'll take you to this page, which will show you your current YouTube channel and the Google account that it's currently associated with. So you'll see here, this is the YouTube channel and it's currently associated with my personal Google account. Now, to move this YouTube channel from a personal Google account to a brand account, you'll be able to select from a list of your brand accounts here, but because we don't have one at all, we have to create one. And for some reason, there isn't just a button right here that says create brand account. So the only way I found to do this is to actually go to a separate web page. And that page is youtube.com/channel_switcher. And this will show you all of the channels that are associated with your current Google account that you're logged in with. So we're going to want to create a new channel. So click on that. And this is the page where you can actually create a brand account. Since there is no more Google Plus, this is the only way I've been able to find it. So you'll see brand account name here. This is one of the benefits of creating a brand account is that you can actually name it your business. You're not restricted to just a first and last name like you are with your personal account. So for now, I'm going to just put in Heather's brand account so that you guys will be able to follow along with the rest of the tutorial. So go ahead and hit create. And now we have our brand new brand account. Now, if you ever want to switch between all of your YouTube accounts, all you have to do is click on the profile icon in the top right corner and then hover down to switch account. And that'll display all of the YouTube channels that are associated with your Google account. So I have the original personal account and then also the brand account that we just created. Lastly, if you want to add multiple administrators, I'm going to show you how to do that really quickly. So you're going to hover over your profile icon in the top right and then go back to your account settings. And then towards the bottom of this page, you'll see a new feature that wasn't there before since we weren't a brand account. It says add or remove managers. So go ahead and click that. And then under manage permissions, you can click on that and it'll show you all of the accounts that have permission to manage this YouTube channel. It's just the account that I had set up earlier. So if I wanted to add anybody, I can click on this icon, type in their email address, and then select their level of permission right here. I just want to point out that if you're trying to move your personal YouTube account to a YouTube brand account, there are some things that are just not going to transfer over, like comments that your channel has made or messages and playlists in your history and stuff like that. I'll go ahead and leave a link to this Google Help article for more information, but that's just something you might want to keep in mind. Okay, to wrap up the video, what are the differences between a YouTube personal account and a YouTube brand account? I'll leave a link to another Google support article that actually breaks all of the differences down, but there are two main differences. First, multiple administrators. If you want multiple people to be able to manage your YouTube channel without you giving them your Google account or your Gmail password and stuff like that, you can create a YouTube brand account. A YouTube brand account kind of does the same thing that a Facebook page does, where multiple people can use their own Google accounts to log in and actually manage the back end of a YouTube channel. So it kind of makes it as a separate entity that multiple logins can go through. So you don't have to pass out your Gmail password to all the people that you want to have admin access to your channel. That's probably the biggest reason you'd want a YouTube account. But the other reason is number two, branding. When you're using a YouTube personal account, it's associated with your personal Google account also. So if your channel name is your business name or like, I don't know, Heather's Cookie Vlogs, that's also going to be the name that's next to your email address when you send out emails in Gmail, right? And then your channel icon is also your profile icon in Google and in Gmail and in Google Docs and all the other, you know, Google services that's associated with your Google account. So creating a Google account, again, makes it like a separate entity. So it can have its own name and its own icon that's separate from what you use in your own personal account. Now that you have a YouTube brand account, should you start a vlog for your business? Check out this video where I break down whether you should start vlogging for your business. Catch you guys later.